Special shout out to Sunrun for making this video possible. If you're thinking about going solar, you got to check out Sunrun at the link in the video description. Over the last few decades, life has increasingly resembled the inspiring worlds of science fiction. We can rapidly access information and make global connections using devices that fit in our pockets. Innovator and futurist Elon Musk hopes to elevate technology to the next level with devices that we wear not on, but inside our own bodies, producing perfect symbiosis between humans and computers. Neuralink began in 2016, with Musk fronting over $100 million of his own money to get the project up and running. Like many of Musk's ventures, Neuralink drew inspiration from science fiction. This particular endeavor directly references Neural Lace, the device from Lane Banks' series, The Culture. Just as with Musk's other projects, the goal of Neuralink are focused and wildly ambitious, to connect the human brain to computers. For the most part, Musk and his team have remained highly secretive about product development since its launch. However, in August 2020, Musk hosted a livestream event where he unveiled some of the company's breakthroughs. The event starred three little pigs who on the outside resembled three happy, healthy, but generally ordinary swine. However, one of the pigs, Gertrude, actually had the company's device implanted in her brain, which recorded signals from her snout. Each time her snout touched something, an array of dots and a series of noises indicated when more neurons were firing. The feat may seem small, but the reality represented a major accomplishment for the company. What's more, Musk disclosed that Gertrude had been wearing the implant for 2 months with no signs of any impact to her health or cognitive function. With Neuralink, Musk and his team have set out to develop a fully integrated brain-machine interface, or BMI. BMI technology isn't new. In fact, its roots began in the mid-20s when scientists first discovered electrical brain activity in humans. Since then, both technology and our understanding of the brain have grown significantly. Typically, BMIs have been used to replace or restore function to people with neuromuscular disabilities such as cerebral palsy, stroke, or spinal cord injury. So far, researchers have used BMI technology to achieve a number of accomplishments, from allowing people with paralysis to walk, to battling various neurological conditions such as depression, and even connecting human brains to computers to control machine interfaces and move robotic prosthetics. In many ways, Neuralink isn't necessarily creating something new, but building upon and improving current BMI technology, making it more widely available and easily accessible in the process. The device Neuralink is working on, which Musk has called a Fitbit for your brain, has three major components. First, the link has hundreds of micron scale high bandwidth threads, each about 20 millimeters long and about a quarter of the diameter of a human hair. Each thread links minute electrodes and sensors resembling a strand of pearls. The threads are arranged in an array consisting of between 48 and 96 threads each, and up to 3,000 electrodes per array. Neuralink threads are smaller and more flexible than those typically used in BMI devices, making them less likely to cause any damage to the brain. They also contain more electrodes than other interfaces, allowing them to extract more brain information. The electrode arrays are housed inside small, circular devices that are surgically implanted into the patient's skull. The data collected by the threads is processed by a chip inside the device, which can be tuned to detect particular types of brain information transmitted by specific neurons within the brain. This information is then transmitted to an external device via Bluetooth to enable wireless monitoring. Of course, if you've ever worked with computers, you know as they process data, they tend to heat up. While an overheated laptop may not feel great on your lap, it would feel even worse inside your head. Fortunately, the Link also has an internal temperature sensor to monitor overheating. If the device starts to heat up as it processes data, it will automatically disconnect to prevent any damage to brain or skull tissue. Finally, the Link includes an external, compact, inductive charger which connects wirelessly to the implant so that the device can be charged from the outside. Alignment lights help users track when the charger is aligned with the device. In general, the Link is designed to be smaller and safer than any other available BMI technology, with more communication channels than any clinically approved device. Ultimately, Neuralink hopes to create a product that can become widely accessible, not only for medical applications, but for the general population. Because these threads on the Neuralink are so fine and flexible, they can't be inserted with the human hand. In order to safely and successfully implant the devices, Neuralink is also developing an advanced surgical robot that neurosurgeons can use to reliably and efficiently place the threads exactly where they need to be without risking damage to blood vessels or brain tissue. The robot laces the threads into the desired location, much like an old-school sewing machine, and can place up to 6 electrode threads per minute. Using the robot, Musk envisions an outpatient procedure that can simultaneously remove the skull fragment, place the electrodes, and implant the device into the space where the skull fragment was removed within a relatively short period of time. Before I get back to the video, I have to tell you about our sponsor, Sunrun. Sunrun is a publicly traded company and the largest solar and home battery installer in America. For my first 5 solar panels I got in 2011, I didn't use a company like Sunrun, instead opting for a small company. Now, they did a great job, but here's the thing, solar products have amazing warranties, but my installer and my panel manufacturer have both gone bankrupt. Working with Sunrun will give you the peace of mind knowing your company has the lasting power to be around when you need them. Here in San Diego, September is usually the hottest and most expensive month. I broke down my solar generation, and without my panels, my bill would have been about $400. With my panels, my bill was a little over $100. But I have a net energy metering plan, so I only pay my bill once a year. The hope is that on cooler months, I'll actually have a negative bill, and over the whole year, my bill will be close to zero. Oh, and that also includes all my driving with my electric car. So maybe you have some money saved up and you want to buy your own panels, or get a loan to buy them. Or maybe you're not quite ready for that kind of commitment and would rather lease your panels from Sunrun. This is their most popular choice, especially if you won't be moving anytime soon. With Sunrun's various options, there is a system for every buyer. Electricity is expensive, but would you rather be paying your utility company to burn more fuels or pay for solar panels on your roof? We've had a lot of wildfires and have had 2 major power outages where I live. One of those left my neighborhood without power for about 8 hours. But with my panels and home battery, I barely even noticed, other than being asked by my neighbors to store their milk and other perishables. Sunrun doesn't just offer solar. With their Brightbox solution, you can add a Tesla Powerwall or LG Chem home battery, giving you a holistic battery backup solution. I went solar a long time ago in 2011, but some of you are waiting for that right moment. Here's my advice. Solar prices have never been better, and the tax credit is 26% in 2020, dropping to 22% in 2021, before going away entirely. With Sunrun, you have the peace of mind of knowing that your warranty will mean something decades from now, and that they'll have the resources to get your project finished on time and done right. Get started with your solar transition using the link in the video's description. While the initial goal of Neuralink is to build off and simplify the current BMI technology mostly for medical purposes, Musk and his team have cast vision far beyond current applications and into the world of science fiction. While the capability to read and interpret brain activity has existed for at least a decade, Musk's broader vision includes allowing the device to successfully write information into the brain using electrical impulses. Imagine the famous scene from The Matrix where, in order to learn Kung Fu, Neo simply inserts a plug into his spinal cord and allows the information to upload. Remember watching that scene and imagining how it would be to learn new knowledge or skills at the speed of a computer? It's this type of human-machine relationship that Musk hopes to one day achieve through Neuralink. Short-term goals for the company involve creating a device that would allow you to control a phone app or a computer, mouse, or keyboard directly using nothing but your brain activity. Neuralink's technology could even allow scientists more options for learning about how the brain works, an area of science that is still largely mysterious. If Musk and his team are able to build out their current breakthroughs, the applications could be endless. Imagine being able to upload memories to the cloud or search for information just by thinking about it. Access your favorite song from within your own mind. These are only a few of the wild ambitions Musk hopes to achieve through Neuralink. Of course, to get there requires jumping through major hurdles in terms of technology and understanding of how the brain systems work. Unlike typical engineering, the keys to understanding how the brain works isn't just a matter of more channels or implants. Instead, it's a code involving a deep understanding of what parts need stimulation in what particular order to produce a particular behavior. To achieve its broader goals, Neuralink has a long way to go. The company has effectively built a metaphorical piano and has begun smashing down on the keys. But there is still a load of work to be done before they can start composing melodies. But as with many of their other ventures, Musk sees Neuralink as something much bigger than just any tech business. While the goals may seem wild and ambitious, they serve more than a mere practical entrepreneurial function. They serve as a fuel to spark the public imagination as to what can truly be achieved through human innovation. With Neuralink, as with SpaceX and Tesla, Musk and his team hope to cast a vision for the future where we as a species realize anything is achievable if we invest our resources and pool our ingenuity. In a recent tweet, Musk said, "Engineering is true magic." What Neuralink has already accomplished is recharging the public with a sense of wonder and excitement about the future, reassuring us that it doesn't have to be scary or foreboding, but that it can be truly inspiring and full of hope. I'm kind of torn about Neuralink. For one, as an engineer, I love this breakthrough. I think the mind is one of the final frontiers. There's so much that we have yet to discover about how the brain works. The use cases are kind of endless. For example, imagine if you were injured in an accident and paralyzed. Imagine a world where you could implant a chip in your brain, the Neuralink, and then a secondary one in your spinal cord, and the two could communicate and reconnect those severed ties to allow your brain activity and your thought process to then control your limbs. These are the kinds of things that would be made possible with Neuralink. As with everything Elon does, he brings that first principles thinking. And here you can imagine, you know, using smaller, more fine, flexible threads, he's going to have better results than maybe what we've had in the past. Plus, I think he's going to make it incredibly cool for new bioengineers or doctors or PhDs to come and join Neuralink and do some of the most cutting edge breakthrough technology research on Earth. And that's kind of been his game. Tesla is probably the most premier location if you're an engineer, if it isn't SpaceX. And this is just another example of a company that can inspire and motivate. The drawbacks, I think, are about privacy and other considerations. Me personally, I don't like the idea of anything that would compromise my privacy. To me, privacy is paramount and far more important than convenience. For you, that might not be the case. But our last video was on Starlink, and since that time, I think there have been some reports that Starlink is going to work with, like, the DoD, the Department of Defense, for contracts and use their technology. And the same might be true for Neuralink in the future. These are companies, after all, that want to make money. And this is where, imagine if the government could come in and say, you know, here's a subpoena. We want all the information from people in this town who have the Neuralink implant to figure out who was doing this at this time. And these companies might be forced under law to hand over this data, even if they don't want to. And this is where anyone who knows me knows I'm a deep believer in very limited government, because I always understand and think that the next person who is elected might change things. If you have a drone program, maybe the next president overuses it around the world. The Patriot Act is still in effect here, and we don't even know how much of our personal text and phone calls are being surveilled. There's just a lot of privacy concerns. And I think Elon did kind of touch base on that, that there's a deep level of kind of privacy built in. But again, the subpoena, if they come from the governments, will require them to pass down data to them. And also, while he was talking about this in the live stream, one of my favorite parts is when he talks about how this is sounding like an episode of The Black Mirror. And that is exactly what I kept thinking. I think the medical breakthroughs are there. This is technology that we should be investing in. But just as with any cutting edge tech like Neuralink or artificial intelligence, stem cell research, we have to also think about the philosophical and the psychological considerations in play. Because we as people might not be really ready or prepared for a world where these things take foot. I'm optimistic. I think this is a really great technology. I'm happy to see them working with it, but it's a bit scary. This one, I think, warrants another video later on. I think we'll do that. We'll cover this again some point down the road when there's more news about it. But incredible stuff. And of course, Elon Musk. Why does it feel like every cool, amazing thing happening around the world, whether it's self-driving cars or rockets or internet from space, it's always Elon. So Elon, make sure you eat healthy and drive carefully because we need you pretty bad here. So that pretty much wraps it up for us. If you're new, please consider subscribing. If you want to be a rock star supporter of this show, consider joining us on Patreon or become a YouTube member. There's a little button there down below. Your support there really helps us to keep making these videos and to keep upping our production value and our quality. So thank you again so much for watching. I'm Ricky with Tuba Da Vinci, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.